The father hadn't eaten in days, he hadn't eaten, but his son was full of spring because he had made money. On this National Depression Day, 2 coins count as a huge amount of money, which can make a family of 7 eat a full meal. The father was surprised and asked his son, where did the money come from? It turned out that the boy had found a casual job at a nearby horse factory to take care of the horse racing, and he did a better job than an adult. The well-dressed horse farm owner praised him. Who would have thought that during the Great Depression, the horse gambling industry could thrive abnormally? Who would have thought that a boy who only loved riding horses and did not like to read could find a place in this impoverished village that spread far and wide? At the age of 15, he was so angry for the first time since he witnessed his parents go bankrupt and his family smashing pots and selling irons and leaving his hometown for a long time. Suddenly looking back, I saw my mother crying silently, and she hugged her tightly, as if she was about to lose it. The boy asked in panic, "What's wrong?" Mom just kept sobbing. The father came with a large bag of books and looked at his son proudly and lovingly. These books were the last gift it could leave him. The boy understood little by little that his parents planned to let him stay in the horse factory to work, but they also had to take the other 4 children to the west to earn a living, and the son's income alone was not enough for 7 mouths. The parents have always loved the most is that this son is desperate to abandon him, and they promised to find a new place to stay. They would call him, and one day they would see each other again, and from that day on, the boy never heard his parents again. After 6 years, the boy grew into a thin and silent man, and people saw that he had red hair and gave him the nickname Cranberry. He had been fired many times over the years, but every job he looked for was related to horse racing. It did not add, and usually could only sleep in people's stables. He eats very little, so even if he is taller than he is, in fact, the weight of the average line is too low to make him a jockey. Xiao Hong Kong has talent, but has not received formal training, riding skills are not good, mentality is not good in horse racing, such as the black horse field of fighting, he has suffered too much destruction, in the defeat after defeat, his self-confidence has also been consumed. In order to make a living, Xiao Hong went to fight the black group at night, and he was hungry, and his fists were weak and seriously injured. Not only that, but I couldn't touch it for 1 cent, and I could only sleep on the bench at the station at night. At the age of 20, he had nothing and tasted the books that his uncle had left him and abandoned his father. He has never sold Xiao Hong's real name, which is John Pollard. It's a true story that took place in the 1930s, when North America suffered an unprecedented Great Depression, and tens of thousands of ordinary people watched their life savings disappear in a matter of days, 25% of the workforce unemployed, and countless families bankrupt. When the house is taken away, eating is a problem. The Great National Migration began, and many North American families were close to their last possessions and sailed to unknown areas, and some people could not go anywhere, so they had to queue up every day to receive relief bread. Although Xiao Hong has been wandering since childhood, but people's hearts are still childish, at least he will humbly plead with the strange horse owner to give him a chance. If people can't look up to him, he is also willing to reduce himself to do the worst horse work. Walking a horse. The salary is extremely low, and Xiao Hong complains to the pony while slipping away, venting the frustration of her life. How can a man be less important than a horse? This look of indignation. I saw a horse trainer not far away, a man named Tom Smith. There is an old saying that Maxima is often there, but Bowl is not often there. Tom is a bull who is more than twice as old as Xiao Hong, but he is as poor as Xiao Hong. He was originally a cowboy on the prairie, who loved nature and life all his life, but under his unbridled urbanization and his curse, he was so destitute that he had to leave the grassland to work in a densely populated place. Because of his strange temperament and taciturn, no one dared to give him Tang Palace. So he lived in isolation, living in the bushes all year round. Recently, he witnessed a batch of white horses with broken front legs. The group slammed them to the ground. His master drew his gun and pointed it at his head, simply because the fractured horse could not be in the race. In a critical moment, Tom stopped the owner of the horse, and he paid for the poor white horse, helped him to pick up the bones, tied the hawthorn roots to his legs, and took good care of him. This move was noticed by a wealthy businessman. The wealthy businessman recently planned to change into the horse racing business. He was looking for high-level talents recommended by horse trainer experts. He was not very satisfied, but he saw that the isolated Tom was alone and saved a white horse. He was very curious about him, and during the conversation between the two, he heard Tom say, "Li Chao." Just because of this sentence, the rich merchant decided to hire him. The rich merchant's name was Charles Howard. More than 100 years old as Tom, he can be said to be the spokesman of the American dream. 20 years ago, Lao Yi was a skilled worker in an automobile factory, dissatisfied with mediocrity, started a car sales company from scratch, and became a big boss in just a few years, buying a 6,400-hectare farm. However, when he went out to work, his son unfortunately had a car accident, lost his breath in the old man's own farm, and under the huge pain of losing his independence, the old man and his wife broke down in their relationship, became alone, and after a period of rest, the old man remarried with another woman. Under his influence fell in love with the horse racing industry. In this way, the old man found Tom and found Xiao Hong. These three are real people, rich or poor, old or young, have received the gift of life, and have also experienced the cruel deprivation of fate. Perhaps in this life, no matter who it is, it will face some heartache. Some people are hurt and beaten down, so the blockade of the true heart is a poison, avoiding injury, but also become numb. However, the above three protagonists will be angry and sad when faced with the pain of life, but they have never given up their life force once. The movie is called The Galloping Age. He also has a fourth protagonist who doesn't play until the exact 44th minute, and he's the legendary Simon C.K. Cowles. When Tom first saw him, it was 5 a.m. and he was led out to warm up.